In the last episode, we exported an MVR file from WYSIWYG lighting design software from CastSoft. This time, I'll show you the easy way to set up your Granime 3 layout to reflect what's in your Granime 3D window. Granime 3 has a great and simple tool that's going to help you make your setup based on your fixture's position in the 3D universe. So if you want to be a better and faster Granime 3 programmer, this tutorial is definitely for you. If you haven't watched the last episode, I'll link it in the corner right now, but you don't have to use that setup. You can follow along if you made your own 3D setup, but you must have some fixtures ready in your Granime 3D window for this technique to work. In the description below, I've shared a OneDrive link where you can download this Granime 3 show file. Feel free to use it for this tutorial if you don't have something of your own set up right now. If you go into the folder, it's the episode 18 folder. So let's get into it. As you might remember from the last tutorial, we imported this MVR file, as you can see right here. And this consists of a lot of fixtures, and building a layout file from all these fixtures in the right position is going to take you a long time. And that's why Granime 3 has a really, really great tool, which is going to help you in that regard. But the first thing here, we look at it in 3D, and then we have our cameras up here, which determines from which angle we are watching it right now. So if I press the front, it's going to show us the front. It's going to show us front and left, left, back left, back, and so on and so forth. And this is something that's going to help us in a minute when we build our layout. But before we build our layout, you have to build a layout view, which I've done here. I have some groups. I have some playbacks here, which we're going to need later. I have some macros for easy access instead of writing everything out in the command line. I have my sequences ready down here. I can see what's in a sequence when I store some. And I have my fixture sheet here. So there's a few different ways you can make a group. First of all, you can, of course, just type the numbers. You can type fixture one through and the last one in that chain of fixtures. And another thing is you can go over here and you can simply drag the cursor down until you select all the fixtures in a certain fixture type. This time I'm going to do it with all our two lights right now. And it's a little bit difficult because it reacts really fast sometimes. But I think I've put in 175 two lights. We have marked them out now. We can simply say store and put them into a group up here. We label the group all two lights like this. And then I'm going to speed up the video and do exactly the same thing for the other moving lights and the other fixtures in our 3D space. Once you've stored everything into its own group, it's much easier to work with. Not that we have to do that, we could actually basically just select all fixtures and put them into the view, but this way we have a little bit more control when we need to work with them later. But as we have done, we have built our layout right here. We just need to scale this a little bit down, and we need our layout pool in here as well. And it's over here somewhere, and we're going to need that in a minute. Let's just store this into our current layout view right here. There we go. So clear this. Now we go. We need our two lights, our atomics, our spiders, mega points, auras, and vipers, and we need to assign them into this layout view. So we have just selected all of them, and we simply say assign, and we put them in here. And as you can see, this is all our fixtures, but they are just in one big long line right now, and we can't use that for anything really. So here comes the cool part. You can go up into your setup menu here with everything selected. You can go into your position down here and you can click it and say arrangement. You can right click this one and say camera. And if you remember before, we used we switch around the cameras in the 3D window. So here in the camera setting, you can simply right click or left click and go up and say, okay, from which angle do I need to set this up right now? If you do it from the front view like this one, it's going to be basically set up the layout if you see it from the front. I love to see it from the top. This is the way I like to work with it. So I select the top view and then we go down into our settings down here and we say apply. And now we actually set up everything as we're supposed to. We can mark everything here and we can take our little move tool here and we can move it into the center. And now we very, very quickly built a layout for our setup. But as you can see, this layout is practically useless because everything is positioned on top of each other. So we need to separate this out the easiest way we can. So we have all our fixtures stored in this first one up here. So when we press that, that's the view with all our fixtures in it. So let's just copy this one and move it down here, and we can relabel this to all atomics, for instance, like this. And then we can go in and select it, and it looks exactly the same because it's a copy, of course. So we say edit, and then we find everything in here which is not an atomic, and we simply delete it. So we start up here with all the two lights, we select them and we delete them. We go below the atomics and we find all the spiders and all the way down, and we delete that. And then we close this one down, and then we suddenly only have all our atomics in our view. But it's still a little clunky because we are looking from the top, and you can see they are a little bit on top of each other. So we just simply select all of them here, all the weird ones from 307 up to 311, 312 here, and we reposition them just a little bit. And this is basically what the layout view is really good at. So let's just do that again and make sure that we selected all of them like this. And then we go into the move tool here and we simply drag them a little bit back. And now we have them all separated. So now we can work a little bit better with them. So let's select all of them and let's go down into our controls down here. And they have a width of 50 pixels and a height of 50 pixels. Let's just increase that a little bit to make them a little bit more visible like we want them. Like this may be 80 and 80. Maybe that's fine. And then we can suddenly much better grab them and move them around the way we want it. So the layout is basically just a starting point when we import it from 3D, and then we can rearrange it a little bit like we just did here. So let's just once again move them into this one, and then I'm going to do the rest of the fixtures right here, and then we're going to go into the next step afterwards. So this time I'm going to speed up the video once again, and I'm going to do all the other views for the other fixtures. And then when we have done that, we can go and proceed to the next step. If you think you have learned something so far, be sure to give this video a like, to give some free support to my channel. I really appreciate it, and it really helps the YouTube algorithm to push my video out to more people. And you're also very welcome to subscribe to the channel. I try to upload a new video every week. So if you want to continue learning Granime 3, this is a good place to be. So subscribe and hit that bell notification so you don't miss any future uploads. Another cool thing we can do after we've done all these layout windows is to give each fixture type its own color. So if we go into the atomics, into the edit again, we can scroll all the way down. I've tried it with some of the different appearances, and it doesn't seem to work for me. I think it's some kind of bug right now in the software. I hope it's going to be better. But I find kind of a workaround is to color the border. And as you can see on all the atomics here, all the borders are hidden, but we can simply mark them all the way down and say visible. And then we can scroll down to border color right here. And then we can mark them once again, and we can choose a border color for our atomic fixtures. So let's just make a kind of a cyan border color right here. Close this one down. And if we clear out, you can see they are all in a cyan color. Once again, I'm going to do this to all of the other fixtures so we can have them each and everyone can have their same color. So now I colored all the different fixtures. They all have their same color, so you can much better differentiate one from the other. I can see there's some similar colors over here, but never mind. The last thing I'm going to show you in this tutorial is to be a little bit more specific about what is in each window, because you can actually draw a large border around a fixture collection, as I'm going to show you right now, like this one. I have this selected, and I can right click on it and go into the setup menu if I can hit the controls, and then we can rename it. This is another element. We can say custom text. We can say all two lights like this. And as you can see, the text comes up here in the center and it's very small. So we can set the default font size to 32, and we can set the text vertical up to the top. And that makes it a lot easier when we go into a setup or into a layout view to see what's actually in it. So if we, for instance, go into, let's say, all our atomics, and let's just say for the fun of it that these ones are on the floor, we can simply choose this plus icon up here, and we can draw a border around these atomics only. And then we can right click, and it can be a little bit hard to hit. We can right click and say floor atomics like this. And you can, it's very hard to see, but there's a small name right here in the center. So we can set the default font size to 32, for instance, and we can place the text all the way to the top, and then we can simply align this this border just a little bit. Oh, I need to change this up a little bit, delete these ones, and then I can just go up with the this border like this. So basically now, if we go out of the setup menu, you will have this one marked out as the floor atomics, and then you know everything else is in the roof or in the trusses. I release a new video every week on this channel, so be sure to subscribe and click the little bell icon if you want to be notified when I release new content. If you are interested in Granum A3, be sure to watch this next video you can see on the screen right now, where I will go through even more Granum A3 features on our quest to learn Granum A3 programming. I hope to see you on the channel again in the future, and until then, happy Granum A3 programming. Bye-bye.